we've been looking at the kind of the nature of violence that women face in the city, such as the streets, the marketplaces, parks, spaces that you have to use on an everyday basis, going to work, going to school, taking your children here and there, to understand the nature of insecurity and fear and violence that women face in public places. All the cities, women face fear. They're fearful of sexual harassment, they're fearful of sexual assault. Across the cities, women said they try to avoid going out at night. So the moment it becomes dark, the city becomes a more hostile place for women. Public transport is a problem. So whether it's the bus, whether it's the train, across the cities we found women saying that they find using public transport a problem. So clearly these two, the fact that women feel scared going out after night and the fact that they face violence in public transport, clearly indicates that women are not equal citizens of a city. They're not able to equally access what the city can offer them. Certainly having the UN Trust Fund providing the resources, certainly for doing something on such a large scale, it's very valuable because each city then is able to share the data that they get and their findings and find it echoed in so many ways in another city across the world. These are deep-rooted patriarchal traditions in all our societies. Through the course of this UN Trust Fund grant, we've developed very strong tools which can be used by anyone. So, and they're very clearly written. How do you conduct a street survey? We have a very extensive guide that we prepared through the project. How do you do focus group discussions? What are the kinds of questions? And the safety audit, how to do it, how many people should be involved, how long it should take, how do you sit down after that and make recommendations? It's not that women have to control their behavior. Now the only solution is that women should dress differently, women shouldn't go out at night. The aim of this entire project or campaign is that to really shift the burden, to say this is an issue of the city, this is an issue of urban governance, this is an issue of urban development. And we need to look at the intersection of violence against women and urbanization in making the city safer for women and therefore safer for everyone. You know, it's just making it a more caring and more friendly and a city that everyone wants to live in and visit.